7 million miles away from Earth, NASA just crashed a $325 million spacecraft into a tiny asteroid at a speed of 14,000 miles per hour. And all of this was deliberate. It is not uncommon for asteroids to hit Earth. In fact, hundreds of meteorites reach the surface of a planet every year. Most of them are extremely small for us to worry about, but there are times when these large rocks can impact the Earth's surface and cause serious damage. Back in 2013, the Chelyabinsk Meteor that exploded over Russia injured hundreds of people. The worst case of an asteroid impact would be the one that visited the Earth about 66 million years ago. Yes, the same asteroid that wiped out the dinosaurs. So should you worry about history being repeated, but this time the human population being the one that's wiped away? Do we need a global defense system to protect us from these foreign threats? How is that possible considering the fact that asteroids are out of our control? The answer to that would be NASA's DART mission, so keep watching till the end to know a lot more about it. Asteroids might be relatively small when you compare them to the size of the planets. But don't let the size fool you into thinking that these are not a threat to our existence. These are the leftovers from the formation of our solar system 4.6 billion years ago. This means that asteroids carry the secrets to how we got here on Earth. At the same time, they are also capable of determining our future. They also have some of the rare metals and several other resources that might help us with future space explorations. So now you might be thinking, are all asteroids the same? Well, no. Asteroids are not round in shape like planets. They are mostly irregular in shape. Some asteroids are hundreds of miles in diameter, while the others can be as small as a pebble. Asteroids are also made of different kinds of materials, but mostly they are rocky bodies made up of clays or metals. What makes them extremely dangerous is when they decide to crash into our planet. Depending on the size, asteroids could wipe out a small area, a country, or maybe the entire planet. Today, with the help of supercomputers and simulations, researchers are working on how to measure the impact of an asteroid that is close to Earth. But there are so many hurdles to this because we don't have enough experience with asteroid impacts to understand the scale of damage that these alien objects can create. The best way to deal with a potential threat of an asteroid would be by redirecting its trajectory. And that's exactly what NASA is aiming for with their Double Asteroid Redirection, or DART, mission. Yes, that's right. And for this, NASA crashed a $325 million spacecraft into an asteroid, and for good reasons. This is the world's first real test of humanity's ability to nudge a threatening body before it could crash into Earth. But how serious is it? What exactly is the significance of this mission? And do we actually need a defense system to protect us from another extinction-level event, similar to what we believe might have caused the extinction of dinosaurs? One of the biggest challenges when monitoring asteroids is the fact that we have a very limited amount of data due to the rare occurrence of large asteroid impacts, and also the fact that we know very little about asteroids when it comes to its density and what they are made of. When most people think about an asteroid impact on Earth, they just think about a space rock smashing against our planet's surface. But that alone is not the best way to measure the impact that an asteroid can have. There are several other variables that need to be considered when estimating the potential damage of an asteroid impact, and one of the major ones would be the amount of kinetic energy that would be transferred to the surface. In the event of an asteroid impact, a huge amount of energy is released in the form of shock waves. The power of this shock wave will depend on the mass and speed at which the asteroid hits the Earth, as well as the terrain. Entry angle is also extremely important in determining the potential damage from these impacts. Higher angle trajectories will result in huge damage as a result of shock waves, tidal waves, explosions, meteorites, and seismic activity. The composition and density of an asteroid are other factors that need to be considered when studying the impact of these celestial objects. When meteors were examined, the vast majority of asteroids that have entered our atmosphere have a rocky composition, and these are the types that are more likely to shatter even before reaching the Earth's surface, and the damage will depend on the fragment size. Then you have metallic asteroids. These are the more dangerous type because they have higher density and are more resistant to the friction caused by the atmosphere, because of which they will have a higher likelihood of reaching the surface intact, which means more damage. Most of our planet is covered by oceans, and there are still so many uninhabited regions on the continents. This means that at the very first glance, the possibility of an asteroid impact causing fatalities is very small. But if an asteroid falls into the ocean, gigantic waves could be formed in the vicinity of the impact side, and it could easily reach the coastal sites. Let's say that if an asteroid impacts a landmass, in addition to a huge shockwave, you'll also see massive amounts of particles that would be released into the atmosphere, which will cause serious environmental damage on a global scale, and that might also be the time you might witness a mass extinction level event similar to what wiped out dinosaurs. So it's clear that the impact of large asteroids will have devastating effects on the planet, no matter where they land. That is why NASA decided to crash their spacecraft into an asteroid, making this the world's very first mission testing planetary defense. The space agency's Double Asteroid Redirection Test, or DART, is here to test the technology to defend Earth against future asteroids and comets by deliberately crashing into an asteroid. In this case, DART was tested against the asteroid that posed no threat to Earth, which was traveling at about a speed of 14,000 miles per hour. This was chosen to be the target, with a larger asteroid's moonlet named Dimorphos that measured about 525 feet wide. The goal of this test was to prove that a spacecraft can autonomously navigate to a specific asteroid and purposefully crash into it, which will disintegrate on impact, changing the object's path and speed. Scientists will also measure the change using telescopes both on Earth and in space. Scientists also launched another spacecraft called the Lycia Cube in an attempt to photograph the collision and resulting debris, and that's exactly how we got all the images to learn more about this impact. Astronomers currently estimate that there are about 25,000 near-Earth asteroids that are more than 500 feet or larger in size, and that will help the researchers with critical data to prepare for a future asteroid impact that might have a catastrophic impact on our planet if we were ever to discover one. The 525-foot-wide asteroid Dimorphos that NASA crashed into is a moonlet that is orbiting another 2,500-foot-wide asteroid named Didymos. Surprisingly, neither of them pose any threat to Earth. But why did NASA choose this particular asteroid system? Well, this double asteroid system was the ideal target for the mission because the effects of the probe's impact can be measured from Earth by precisely timing how the moonlet's orbital period around Didymos changes as a result of the collision. The DART mission was a result of years of planning and a 10-month voyage from Earth to the Didymos-Dimorphos system. This could be a new era for humankind, an era where we will have the capability to protect ourselves from something as dangerous as an asteroid impacting something that we never had before. Right now, you could say that planetary defense is a globally unifying effort simply because of the fact that it affects everyone living on Earth. A change in the trajectory of the asteroid is all it takes to keep humanity alive. At least, that's the best we can do with the technology that we have, and it would make a huge difference. The Didymos-Dimorphos double asteroid system offered an ideal planetary defense test because the moonlet's orbit carries it directly in front of and then behind the Didymos as viewed from Earth. This will allow scientists on Earth to precisely measure slight changes in the combined reflected light from both asteroids. Researchers will be able to calculate how long it takes for Dimorphos to complete one orbit, which right now is 11 hours and 55 minutes, and post-impact observations will allow them to determine what effect this mission might have had on this asteroid system. Researchers are expecting this crash to shorten the asteroid's orbital period by about 10 minutes, but it will still take a few days or even a few weeks for telescopes around the world and in space to give us more insights on the after effects of the impact. This is also the very first time both Hubble Space Telescope and the James Webb Space Telescope are given the same target. Ultimately, the DART mission has two primary objectives. The first one being a test of our ability to build an autonomously guided spacecraft that will actually achieve the kind of kinetic impact that is required to redirect the path of an asteroid. The second is the test of how the actual asteroid responds to kinetic impact. This will also give us an insight to what kind of impact will be required in the future if we were to protect ourselves from an asteroid impact. Once we figure out asteroids, these bodies will also help us deal with the supply issue that we might face if we were to set up a colony on Mars or the Moon, because there are evidence that suggests that there are trillions of dollars worth of materials and metals buried in asteroids. However, the good news is most asteroids that we keep a track of currently do not pose any significant threat to our planet. But it's still important for us to keep an eye on these foreign objects because they are capable of wiping out life on our planet. And as far as we know, planet Earth might be the only place where life exists in the entire universe.